비춰진 미로 속에 우린 저 벽 넘어 서로 볼 수 없지만 Turn it up, turn it up 네 마음을 들려줘요 It's running time
Winter is nearly coming to an end on the Endless Corridor. Snow is beginning to fall and grass has started to grow everywhere. Even on Gordon's Hill, but the snow had slid out a so lot. Well, the slopes under the tracks, they're already started to gain way and definitely becoming unsafe. The engines know that very well, and they had to continue their work as well as they continue with going up Gordon's Hill, as well as their passenger trains do. Even they having trouble struggling going up and down while the tracks were a little close to derailing them. But back at Tipmonth, the engines were awaiting their work. Ah, yes. Spring is coming next month. Oh yes, of course. Oh, thank goodness. I'm sick of all this snow anyway. I see the animals are already starting to wake up early. Come to mention it, they're already starting to get practicing to meet their mates. Why is that? Oh, I get it. Granny ready to take them out for dates? Like one of those date things that people are preparing them for? No, I mean, they're shoving their, well, I could say it in front of, well, dicks. Oh, and what do you mean by that? Henry, you heard about the magic tree, right? Oh, yeah. Are they grinning? They're already grinning wishes. Not that magic tree. Then which magic tree you're talking about?
Go on, magic tree. Let me feel all that magic in your throat.
You know what? Let's just say they're practicing to give birth to new babies, okay? And let's just keep it that way. Alright. Oh, I'm more excited to see how well they all work together. Oliver, may I just say that, hey, Dad, you're not gonna do those things, right? I don't know what you meant by things, but I do know what you meant by going up Gordon's Hill. You do realize that hill is definitely unsafe. Hey, look! Hey, look what? It's her own helicopter flying through the sky! Attention all engines at Tetmouth! Gordon's Hill is completely running closed for repairs. We might need to run 11 straights at the track. It's not safe for any engines with larger loads who's coming up there or down there. Best for engines pulling a few less heavy trains or light, light passenger trains must pump slow and carefully up and down the hill, otherwise they'll derail. Please, as for big engines who comes around, goes around Gordon's Hill, oh, might as well do that safely. Please use another line if you're hauling a heavy train. That is all. Thank you. Well, now that's a warning that he definitely gave us from the Fat Controller. I'm pretty sure it's from the Paw Patrol doggy. We're not so sure that if what's going to happen up next in the outcome. Yes, of course. I know, but I really hate to, I have an express train. If you don't mind, I'll show you. Gordon, the express engine, hop onto the turntable and prepare to leave. And he's taking an express train to the mainland. And who knows how long he'll be gone. Tell all our friends that they're goodbye to the big blue engine as he hops over the unsafe over Gordon's Hill. The light engine, he cuts straight over to the land. As for James and the rest of the other engines, they lie wait for the Fat Controller to show up. Till then, in about 10 minutes later, he had. And ready for the instructions to give. Gordon is off to the mainlands and to pull the express. And a special one as well. So he won't be returned until a week. In the meantime, I need all of you engines to continue doing your work. James, you do your passenger train. As soon as you're done, you need to take the express for Gordon while he's gone for a week. Emily, you must go take passengers and help Thomas and Toby on their branch lines. And Donald, Douglas, you take the slow goods trains to the docks. And Henry, you pull the flying kipper. And while that's done, you take the goods train tonight. And what about me, sir? Oliver, since Percy is already doing some shunting on his branch line, and since he got a late start since a few accidentals on the main line by a few lost dinosaurs, don't know how they ended up and around the railway, stuffing everywhere. I'm afraid that you had to do his mail work. Oh, that's kind of sound fun. Toad is already there, so you should be ready to take the train. Oh, so they got a head start for me. Well, Thomas usually sent a Toad over there for him. And later on, he'll take a few oil tanks to Plaza Railroad. In the meantime, please don't go sightseeing again like the last few times. Oh, Can I at least go and take a shortcut to adventure? No! Well, can I at least go check on Salty and see it? No! May I at least... No! I wasn't gonna say anything! I know what you're gonna say, but it's gonna be something stupid! You didn't even know what I'm gonna say! You would like to go to a hobby shop! Well, yes! No! Alright, sir. In that case, I'll do it. In the meantime, Oliver popped straight to hit Percy's mail vans and coupled up. And now he's ready to go. Okay, all set to go, sir! Lead the way, Mr. Oliver! And please don't get lost on the way again. And as they set off, they pop straight to Gordon's Hill. Time after on done all of their deliveries, Oliver shunts Percy's mail van and clean tone into the siding on his last stop on his way.
Woo! Well, that was fun. I wonder what the other work I'm gonna have to do next. Oh! Hey! Toad! Yes, Oliver. I'm in. Oh, it's Edward!
Oh, you're right! Look what he's doing here.
Hey, Oliver, Toad! I'm glad you finally came.
Yeah.
Well, we finally came before.
Yeah, you see, you two. I need to pull a goods train, but I also need to do the shunting duties, but Mavis and Bill and Ben and Arya Bird are not around here. So maybe perhaps you kiss, I don't know, give me a wheel and shunting trucks while I'm gone. And in the meantime, I would really like for you to take a few wagons down to the, well, the repair yard station.
And one question, Edward. Why there's a salt wagon on the flatbed there?
Oh, right. Its chassis seemed to be, breaking up. So we're just gonna need to, replace it and get a new one. I just took it to the steelworks to have it fixed.
Oh. Alright then. In that case, no need to worry. We'll help you along the way. And be careful with the snow and ice.
Nice, Edward. The winter is maybe melting, but the rails are still a bit slushy and slippery.
I got my salt cars, Toad. Oliver, are you listening?
Yeah, I am. But one question, Edward.
What?
What's a salt car?
Sandbox, I mean.
Oh, okay then. Good luck with that!
In the meantime, Edward left, along with his heavy goods train. And during through the hours, he started shunting. Done.
Roundhouse Station for some rest. But not for long. Brewster and Wilson are feeling a bit under the weather, so they won't be ready until tomorrow. Ernie asked Edith to the other engine to see if they're feeling up to it, but they all got other works to do.
Hey, would you mind telling me what this is all about?
I'm narrating here, thank you. Just wait your turn. Okay, yeah. Okay, where was it? Oh, yes. So, he turned to the other four engines.
But frankly, luckily, one of them is all set to go back home.
So, I guess I'm taking a special train to the... come to different sheds, right?
Just be careful not to break yourself again, Oliver.
It's like I'm in a digital circus or something.
Tell me about it, Coco.
In the meantime, the Paw Patrol were already examining the tracks. They could see some of them were a bit unstable. The Earth had been weakened by the snow and ice very well. So the pups had to be very cautious. In the meantime, back at Nelfert, Toad is already coupled up between the coach and the flatbed of mine cars. As Hot Wheels cars, actually. Toad was feeling anxious.
I hope Oliver isn't going to screw this up. We haven't screwed up on the milk cars yet.
A coach named, Coer, is already coupled up in behind Toad, but already covering up, not to worry.
Well, on the plus side, Toad, at least the journey home wouldn't be so terrible.
Oh, hey, look, there's Oliver!
Huh?
And there he was. Oliver puffed straight into Nelfert. Well, outside of Nelfert Junction. But Molly took a good long look. A train definitely needed to be taken, alright. But also another train of mail vans that someone else is supposed to take. That I do not know yet, but we'll know for sure in further time.
Well, at least you be going somewhere, right, Spikeball?
Don't talk to me, you idiot.
Well, Coach, looks like you're stuck with us now.
Perhaps I am, Oliver. Just hope you're not gonna, take a wrong turn.
Come on, what do you think I have, alright? Of course I know where I'm going.
I'm coupled up between you and a flatbed of mine cars.
Yes, Oliver, just please be careful not to crash. Just a reminder, I got a few workers in here, so at least pump a little bit safely.
Don't worry. I know where I'm going.
Up we go!
In the meantime, the pups were placing a scanner, showing if anything is going fine, and to see the top speed on the engines, and being sure there aren't any high-speed trains, and also to check if the track is safe to be popped down or not. Well, do you think it's fending right? I sure hope so. Especially for high-flying lizards like dragons. Well, just so you know, Claw might be coming over real soon. Oh, yeah, we haven't seen him in ages. I really hope no engine is foolish enough to pop down that fast. Hey, look! There's Oliver! I wonder why... Hey, wait! He seemed to be pumping a bit fast. Oh, he's pumping fine to me. Whoa, wait! He's pumping too fast! Oh, wait! Whoa! Oliver! Hold on! Hi, Pops! Bye, Pops! Oh, wait! Oliver! Oh, dear. Really hope it isn't so fast. Well, I'm sure he's fine. Let's just check the scanner. Ooh. I think the correct word is he's fine for now. Boy. Here I am in the bottom of the hill. I wonder why that I had to wait around this station for anyway. Huh? Oh, it's Oliver coming down with the... Whee! What was that noise? The sound of inner stupidity, my friend. The sound of inner stupidity. And he is right. Luckily, no one was hurt. Except the fireman, the driver, the yard manager, and some other people. But, you know, no one important. And luckily, the mess isn't that big. Or in the, well, as for the minecarts, well, quite damaged. But you get the point. I can't believe you went down high speed. Oliver! I thought you said you know what you're doing! What? In the meantime, the fat controller arrived, and he is not happy with what just happened. Oliver, you had caused confusion and delay. And you caused a serious accident, too!
What kind of accident?
You're just lucky that those fuel tankers that James is pulling hasn't exploded!
Sir? James might need a little bit some repairs, and Oliver, I think he's just taken a few damage, that he'll be ready. They'll be ready to work again real soon.
And, would you mind checking these? Don't worry. We'll have them fixed in a jiffy. Thomas, would you mind taking those fuel tankers for James while we get him fixed?
Sure thing, Ryder.
Marshall!
Sky, see if anybody here is alright, and also to get some people to a hospital fast as you can. And be careful with the giant snowdrift might fall on top of you.
Oh, come on. It's only gonna fall, gotta fall right on top of him.
I'm good. Meanwhile, back at Gordon's Hill, Ryder and his pups, including Wild, are checking to see the scene of the crime of the track. So far, it's every single thing seems fine and sturdy, but the earth is already giving way. Thomas, however, has to take the tank train to Nowford Station for change, since he is already going to be repaired. In the meantime, he has to get over Gordon's Hill as slow and a little bit quickly as he could. Otherwise, he might derail. In the meantime, Thomas did arrive at Nowford, and Brewster was there waiting. Hey, Brewster! Oh, hey, Thomas! What happened? Did some accident happen on the railroad? Huh. Yeah. Jane just ran into an engine with a number 11 on it. Don't tell me. Yeah. Oliver certainly made a mess of things. Hey. By the way, wasn't he supposed to take the freight car full of tankers downhill? Scruffy has already started to be loaded with them right now. Last time I checked. Well, yeah, I guess I'm gonna have to do that job too. But no one's perfect. Thomas, do you think you should get a brake van before you go downhill? Don't worry. With one single truck, I can make it back before midnight. I'm not so sure, Thomas. I don't think it might be safe. Don't worry. Scruffy will be wearing a headlamp by looking back. I'm sure of it. I'll be fine. Trust me. All right. But we better talk to the railroaders about this. Oh, there's my whistle. Well, I'm off. Bonk, bonk. See you later, Thomas. Bye, Brewster. Have a safe journey home. Back down at Tippa's sheds. Coco is having a conversation with the steam engine at Tippa. I can't believe that you crashed another train, Oliver. What were you thinking? You just got your friend James in a terrible accident. And you damaged my buffers. That's as much as you put huge scratches on my paintwork! Oh, it's alright. You too? The important thing is that you're still alive! Yeah, alive. If only I would kill you right about now! Would you mind please letting it go? Thomas will be home tonight, and hopefully he'll be here right before the storm. Arm comes. In that case, I hope that that Thomas will give you a piece of my mind. Not if I give him a piece of my mind first, James. Now, would you please keep it down? I'm trying to watch the movie. I'm guessing our conversation must be very loud.
Very loud indeed.
Hey, Scruffy, looks like it's just going to be you and me puffing straight down on Gordon's Hill. So you just don't give me much of a hard time, alright? Hey, without the rest of my other truck friends, I'm harmless as a house cat. Well, not all house cats are harmless, that's for sure. Hey, I know devious is mere humdinger kitty catastrophe meant. Guess you could say something like that. let's just go already. In time, they're off. But where did they know trouble is around the bend? A cold blizzard winter storm blew around the mountain. Well, around Gordon's Hill, I mean. Till then, some of the track feet started to gain way. The earth quickly crumbled, and the track broke. Later as they know, the little blue tank engine and the freight car are on their way to the disaster. Oh, well, a very windy storm, wasn't it? Thomas, I gained a bad feeling about this. Oh, calm yourself, SC Ruffy. No need to be. Just a bird blizzard. I'll be back home and get one in no time. Maybe I should have gotten my snow plowed. Huh? Hey, wait. I'm sure feels kind of weird. Thomas? I think you better stop. Hold on. Just a down in the air and I... Thomas, don't say it! Guess I should have stopped. At the little blue tank engine in the trunks of the truck, laid dates on its side and upside down. They had no choice but to wait for help. Only after the storm passed, there's an alarm. Oy, oy. What was that strange looking sound? Hey, it's it. Both Percy and Douglas saw Toby puffing past, pulling Henrietta and the flatbed. And not to mention the van, in case you're wondering. Well, that's strange. Why is Toby in such a rush and a hurry at this late night and hour? I don't know, but I'm getting a bad feeling about this. The next day, the accident was a tragic. Wilson, however, had popped to help his friend Thomas, while Thomas and Scruffy were being rescued. The pups were helping them as well, and they're preparing to get them back on rails. Scruffy, however, is on the flatbed, while Thomas, however, is still being rescued. Oh dear, said Henrietta. I hope you're alright after this. I gained a feeling they might be needing some repairs for a long time, said Sky. Back in Nelford, Ryder explained the whole thing, what happened to the engines, and therefore, Thomas, will be in repairs for about a month. So he asked one of the engine that they should do his job for him. Percy and Douglas, however, had other jobs to do, and Duck clearly had to do his work. James is still in repairs, and while Coco, she's needed back for the express. But as for Oliver, he's already repaired and all set to go. I think. Well, Oliver, do you think you're feeling up to it?
Oh, I ever!
Okay, but be careful. Gordon's Hill is not so easy to climb. Especially back down. And he's right. The hill looks a little weaker than ever. The tracks have been repaired, but the slope is still slipping. And much less as safe for going down and up with high speed. But in the meantime, Oliver had set off eyeing off the turntable and went to find Annie and Clara. And now that's done, he puffs a little bit quickly up on Gordon's Hill, not noticing the slopes is getting much, much bigger. Now Oliver is collecting paint cans to add to his train. Coco, however, is taking the mail cars. Pretty much he's just taking the mail. Till then, when it's time for her to go, she left. Be careful with the rails, Oliver! Toot toot!
I will be careful, all right, he said.
Okay, lady, let's be prepared to go and have our passengers set up. We don't want to cause any delay.
You don't want to cause any delay for the Fat Controller. You were here because Thomas was in an accident. Careful, Oliver! You don't want to do the break your birthday this week! And I got a feeling that the troll might not give out so easily.
It's alright, ladies. Everything will be just... Woo! That's the whistle! Well then, let's go, shall we?
Like we have a choice.
Well, out we go to you know where.
Oliver continued puffing around the countryside. Much well, he's enjoying the run. But by the time he reached Gordon's Hill, he stopped and stared. Oh. Well, this certainly looked kind of unsafe. They even have a platform under the track. Of course they have, Oliver. What else? You should really should pop slowly, otherwise you might pop down much too quickly. Ooh, quickly. Oliver, I really suggest that you should be a lot careful for both your, me, Henry, well, Annie, and the passenger's sake. We don't want to cause another accident, now do we?
All right, I understand.
Well, good. Well, I'm glad you understand. Well, I understand, and that means we might have to be a lot more injuring.
Now, aren't we?
Okay.
Pop, don't pop down too quickly. What? Pop too quickly! Too quickly? Yes.
What? No!
You okay? No, wait!
Oliver must quickly straighten around the van, straight round the shadows.
Right to the turntable where Edward was turning out down for work. But while Oliver is pumping straight too fast,
while Thomas was still being repaired, Harold.
Oh, what the use! Alright, stop the whole thing. I'm curious. I need to read the script. Okay, I got it down.
Meanwhile, Edward is on the turntable, turning around, getting ready for work. Thomas is almost done, getting prepared. Harold the helicopter is relaxing. And Thomas is already having a conversation with Edward before he's about to leave when... What was that?
Oh, not again.
What was that noise?
The sound of inner stupidity, my friend. The sound of inner stupidity. And he's right. Paint cans flew everywhere. That was derailed off the turn, nearly off the turntable. Anya and Clabro were completely off the tracks. What shattered glass windows. But luckily, this time, no one was hurt. In the meantime, the Paw Patrol came to clear up the mess. Rubble shunted Annie and Clarabelle up on the proper line, while Sir Tavenant said stern, angry words to our great western idiot.
Oliver! This is the second time you crashed! There's another train this week! What do you have to say for yourself?
Hey, sir. I got the paint on for you.
Yeah, and you got them down in a faster pace. Just in a terrible accident.
You know, I think you should give him a safer job where he won't be stupid enough to go down hills too fast.
Great idea. And thanks for your and thanks to your answer. You just gave me a wonderful idea to make sure this idiot doesn't cause any more trouble for my railway. Hey, Chase, our friend Everett still needs a little help shoveling the snow off the tracks in Adventure Bay. Meanwhile, in another distance, a new friend comes join the team.
Little baby, see.
there, friend.
Hey, Claw! Long time no see.
It's almost been a year, hasn't it?
Exactly, my fellow knight. And it's been a while since I haven't been back on the railroad.
Since my automobile isn't working right, I have to have Spots fly over here for me.
Wow! So that's a real-life dragon!
This is the first time I've ever seen one! An in-person!
Wow! Rosie! You must have been a long time to see!
Too long, I say, Claw. I haven't seen you since Bungling Bird. It's Buffling Bird. Oh, whatever you call it.
I must say, you must be doing pretty good shunting, and are you still doing the pairs on this hill?
Yes, of course.
Well, you know, got a few accidents. Mostly one of them, right? Yeah, Oliver keeps running into trouble. Oh, yes, I heard. The writer just called me about it, and I definitely do not want to hit a red, because I already know about the red.
Don't remind me.
You heard the news?
Yeah, Gordon is coming back.
Yeah, it's already been a few weeks.
He's already coming through Adventure Bay.
You think you might see Oliver along the way?
I got a feeling he's gonna be rich.
Almost. Can't wait to stretch my real pulling the express. Wonder how my fellow tanking friends are doing.
Oliver! What are you doing under your past note?
Hey, gorgeous. I think I got stuck in the snow.
Don't tell me.
Tell you what. I need a poop.
Well, that episode turned out a little bit ridiculous. But anyhow, at least we got some laughs out of it. Not sure you find it funny, but at least it's a little good. Well, just to say, sure, next month the episode will be a lot different than you expected, but as I would say, I think that, okay, so far some of the characters are acting a bit stupid and ridiculous so far, except for some, like Ryder and the Pups, but still, I know that a new member of the team just came, and that would be Claw. And not only that, starting this month, I'm uploading in a day, every day after tomorrow. Yes, and after tomorrow will be in My Little Pony Efforts. And that is where we're going to start the montage of that. It'll be an AMV after the next. Well, next week is going to be a villains of the video and the one and a few weeks later, it's going to be a video game effort. I'm looking at the calendar. I know. All right. So I made a lot of AMVs for this month so far. But still, I hope you might like them. And also, it may take a little bit longer than I expected.
And yeah, the new Pokemon on Advance is already happened. And then Pokemon Day just passed by, and perhaps the game might be interesting or ridiculous. But it won't matter, because I'm going to enjoy playing with them and transferring Pokemon. And hopefully I can transfer the Pokemon from Gen 6 to 9 in that new Black and White series. Since the 3DS version is already passing on, and the Pokemon Bank is already closing down, and I took too long, didn't I? Well then, thank you all very much for watching, and I'll see you again in...
This world is not meant for you. Run, boy, run. They're trying to catch you. Run, boy, run. Running is a victory. Run, boy, run. Beauty lies behind the hills. Run, boy, run. The sun will be guiding you. Run, boy, run. They're dying to stop you. Run, boy, run. This race is a prophecy. Run, boy, run. Break out from society. Tomorrow is another day, hey. And you don't have to hide away, yeah. You'll be a man, boy. But for now it's time to run, it's time to run. Tomorrow is another day, hey. The night fades away, yeah. You'll be in my boy. But for now it's time to run, it's time to run.
Okay, that's long enough.